yeah, I love being loved. It's something that I don't take for granted. I love it. But I just want to be grounded. I just want to continue to just be this human that is still growing, because I don't have all the answers. It may seem like I know it all, you know what I mean? But I don't have all I know is that I do not know.
Are you hard on yourself as a dancer? Because like me as a dancer, I critique myself really, really hard. Like after I watch myself, mm-hmm. like, I prefer myself, mm-hmm. like, damn, I did that better, or this should have been like that.
Mm-hmm.
Are you like you critique
yourself? I used to be like that. But then I realized that I don't thrive off of putting myself down. You can be hard, there can be a sense of discipline, but when you critique yourself, when you do a dance routine or when you do whatever, you also have to give yourself love back. Does that make sense? You have to have that balance. It's cool that you don't just take anything. You want to be good, you want to be better, you want to be this, that, and the other. You know what I mean? And I get it, because I want to do the same thing. But the minute that I'm just like, damn, that move, that routine, then that, da-da-da-da. It's like you're like slapping yourself, but then you forget what you did. You forgot that you actually did it. You forgot that you actually came and took the class. You forgot the work that it took to get this piece. Even though it may not be perfect, I still have this. Still have it, and I did it. And there's some people out there that are still sitting on their couches, like, you know what I mean?
Right.
There's still people there wishing that they would have done that. So it's all about keeping the balance. Even for myself, sometimes I have to correct myself, because I'm like, oh, when I look back at like when we that combo, I'm like, really? Yeah. And then watch this. But when we is what got me booked with Tank.
Right.
When we is like kind of one of the routines that actually got Queens N Lettos big. So it's like, why?
That routine is so
hot. but to me, because I've grown so much, I say, damn, if I were back to when we now, ooh, I would fuck that shit up. I would fuck that shit up. But it's like, it's the growth and it's the balance. It's growing. But give yourself some credit sometimes, y'all. Give yourself some credit sometimes. Like, we're all here. We're all just trying to be happy. And just work for ourselves, and just to live a fulfilling life with no regrets. We have to learn from something. You know what I mean? So don't be. You can be hard on yourself. You can have a little bit of discipline, but also have the same amount, if not more, love.
Do you ever get like starstruck when you get reposts? Like, how did you feel like when Chris and Nikki and Black Minister was sharing your videos? Like, I think Chris had shared your privacy video like a long time ago.
Yeah.
Like, how do you feel like when you keep reposting your videos? Because I know you reposted on Hope You Do like last year.
Yeah. So the first time I got reposted by him, obviously it was like, damn, like that's crazy. It was more, I did get, you know, a little starstruck, and I realized, I was like, oh my God, an artist, you know, of his stature is looking at me and is reposting me and whatever. But when it started to continue, I realized that it's normal now. He's supposed to be doing that. I'm glad he sees me. It's about fucking time. That's kind of what it's like. And I start to look at celebrities now as human beings, not, oh my God, like you are this. We're all one, y'all. We are all one. They are humans just like us, and they are on their own paths, doing what they love to do. Good for them. I'm gonna be right there with you. There's no difference between Beyonce and I. There's no difference between Chris Brown and I. There's no difference between Nicki Minaj and I. Maybe our bank accounts, but maybe our bank accounts and maybe the thing and the things that they have, but I'm right there with them. I'm right there with them. I'm not there yet, but I'm gonna get there. You know what I'm saying? So when we look at celebrities, yes, there. When you guys look at me, yes, it starts. You know, it's crazy because of whatever the reason. But then I'm sitting on the floor just like you guys. Like I'm talking just like you guys. I was right there with you. We are just on different paths, and it's a beautiful thing. That's it. We're all just going through life trying to get to one destination, which is being happy and just being a loving person and trying to help one another get there. There is no difference between celebrities and I now. I finally took that concept, and now like if Beyonce were to walk in the room, I would be like, oh shit. But then it's like, difference. What's up? You want to learn this routine? Let's get it. And that's how, and I think that's how Nikki finally like got liked me, because I didn't treat her like a celebrity. Oh my God. Okay, what do you need? Do you need to do that? I'm like, do it again.
Right.
Again. You want the show to be good. Then I feel like celebrities actually appreciate when somebody else treats them like a human being and not a celebrity. You know what I mean? I get that concept. Just, they're another human being, y'all. They're just like you. Mm-hmm. We're just all on our different paths and on different levels, and that's it. That's it. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Oh, I have two questions.
And yes.
My first question is, have you ever thought about, because you have Queens N Lettos in LA. Have
yeah.
Have you ever thought about having Queens N Lettos and different
makeup? Yeah. A different place. I'm looking. Yeah. I hire people. You know those people who are sometimes so annoying, but they get what they want because they won't take no for an answer.
Right.
They won't take no for an answer. There's people where I'm like, man, you're doing all that. You're being a little extra. But it's like, bitch. Do you guys know my friend Melissa?
Yeah.
Melissa Molinaro.
She's having a baby.
She's having a baby. Look. So we did the Ellen show together for the lemonade thing, right? She came with a big bag of clothes. She has her line, her clothing line, and she brought them. I'm like, bitch, why are you bringing all those clothes? She was like, bitch, just watch this. I was like, okay. She was going to every single person, like, I'm sorry, is Ellen here? Like, I really want to give her this bag of clothes. Is Ellen here? Then I'm like, bitch, you are never gonna get to Ellen. She is not gonna do all that. She's gonna be like, bitch, my girl, get out of my face. But she finally found one person that was like, oh, these are for Ellen? Oh, cool, like, I'll take it. And she came back to the rehearsal studio. The bag full of clothes was gone, right? Then we go out right before we did our performance, right before we start shooting. Ellen herself comes out and is like, where's Melissa? Is there a Melissa here? And Melissa was like, that's me. Ellen DeGeneres came up to her and was like, thank you so much for this bag of clothes. Like, I really like this red sweater. I'm gonna wear it, da 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 da. And gave her a hug, and Melissa was like, I was like, okay. I get it now.
Who's talking? You said no.
Oh, taking no, using your resources, going to every single person until one person gives you that opportunity, dancing, going to every single audition, going to these classes, coming to every single one of my classes until I make you a fucking queen of Queens N Lettos myself. Not taking no for an answer. It's a yes. I'm gonna get what I want. Just a feeling, and it's just like, it makes you excited. That's what life is. That's what life is. I can't explain it to you guys, but you have to. You are responsible for your own happiness.
Yeah.
You have a choice. You have a choice. And if you have to, because we have to take care of our responsibilities, I'm not telling you, know, take care of your responsibilities or whatever. Put food on the table if you have children. Take care of your children. Take care of your house or whatever. But you gotta make time for that thing. Whatever that thing is, you have to. Because that's what heals you. That's what... You ready?
Yeah.
All right. Thanks.